Hi, I'm Mike Marin, and in this video, we'll discuss how to export data out of R. Quite often, after working with some data in R, we've made some changes or calculated some summaries, and we'd like to export this and save it as a file outside of R. As an example, we'll export this data here out of R. I've kept it short and simple so that it can be easily viewed. I've also saved it in an object named data2export. You can find links to download a copy of this data, as well as the R script used in this video, in the video description below. The most flexible command for exporting data is the write.table command. To access the help menu for this command, you can place a question mark in front of the command name, or search the command in the help search window. Let's begin by saving the data using mostly the default values. We will use the write.table command. We'll specify the data that we'd like to export here, being data2export. Then we can specify the name we'd like to save the file as. We'll save it as exportedFileName.csv. We use the sep argument to specify the file format or separator for the values. Here we will separate values using a comma. This is also known as comma separated values or CSV file format. Exporting the file this way will save it in our current working directory. Now let's submit that command here. To learn how to set your working directory, you can see one of our other videos discussing this topic. Let's take a look at that file. We can see the file saved here in our current working directory. If we double click on this file, it will open in Excel by default. We can see that by default, R has saved the row names, and we probably don't want these here. We can get rid of these by setting the row names argument equal to false. So let's go ahead and do that. You can see here we've set the row names argument equal to false. We should also note that exporting this file using the same name as before will overwrite the previously saved file without giving us a warning. Let's go ahead and submit these commands here. And let's go take a look at that file. We can see now this file looks as we'd like it to. Now, let's discuss how to save this file somewhere other than the current working directory. In order to save this file outside of the current working directory, we'll also have to include the path to where we would like to save the file along with the file name. So let's run this command here, and let's go check on that file. Here we can see within the teaching folder and then this folder to save in folder, we have the exportedFileName.csv file we've just saved. And again, the file looks as we'd like it to. Now let's look at a few alternatives. Instead of using the write.table command, we could also use the write.csv command, and this will not require using the sep equals comma argument, as it is implied in the write.csv that we would like this to be saved as a comma separated value file. So let's submit this command here. One command we won't show here but worth mentioning is the write.csv2 command. This is used some places in Western Europe, and this would use a comma for a decimal point and a semicolon for a separator rather than a comma. Now, the reason that we've focused on the write.table command in this video and not the write.csv command is it allows for saving in other file formats. For example, we can export the file as a tab-delimited text file by setting the file extension to .txt and a separator of /t, which would tell R we'd like a tab-delimited file. We can do that with this command here. The file can also be saved using a space to separate values. Here we would just leave a blank space in the sep argument, as we can see here. Let's submit this command here. And let's just take a quick look at those other two files that we've created. We can see here is the tab-delimited text file. And if we double-click that, by default it'll open in a text editor, and we can see values are separated by tabs. And just to compare, here's the file that we saved using a space to separate values. And again, if we double-click that, by default it will open in a text editor, and we can see values are separated by spaces. I hope this video has given you the tools you need to export data from R in the file format that you like. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe to our channel, like us on Facebook, visit our website, and check out our other instructional videos.